Glastonbury Fringe Festival. It's very similar to Glastonbury, other than it's not quite so loud. We have fresh, cool water and wine, and we have flushing toilets. Other than that, it's exactly the same. Now, the first piece you'll see on the programme, there's one of these pieces, all very short pieces, so we'll get through them pretty nicely and quickly. But it'll give you a big variety of different types of music and show the skills of the people behind me here. The first piece, I call it the first, is because it's when I first met Byron, who is the trumpeter here, back in May 1982 in Somerton, and we were playing this piece. It's the first piece we've ever played together, so we're going to play it for you again now. It's written by a chap called Gray, who became the standard for violin tutors and playing. So we're going to be able to play a piece which is for organ and trumpet, nothing to do with violin. He was pretty good at that as well.
Thank you.
Sonnet Nick is from Bach Formulas, written by Bach Formulas, and it's considered to be one of the finest early songs that he wrote. He often criticised himself for his early music, saying that I'm really not very good at this. I really don't know what I'm doing, the structure's very poor. These pieces were found quite late on, and actually once they were heard and played, he realised that he was just putting himself down, and he's written some of the most beautiful songs ever. Flat and Beethoven's piano concerto number 3 from memory with a full orchestra. test, but not bad. But he had a rather sad life. In 1878, he was on holiday with his wife at a spa, and he sent a letter saying he was never coming back. He just walked out of the hotel and never came back. And they only met once again in 1881. They never divorced. When he died, there was a lady dressed in black at the back of the funeral procession who was his wife. He'd always come and followed his work, but they were never together. Nobody knows why. But very sad. But he wrote some wonderfully emotional music, some of which you can hear now.
Thank you. Tobacco, sing sweetly for tobacco. sciolta d'amore la sera tu, Vittoria, Vittoria, mio cuore.
same rainbow's end, waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend, river and me.
Thank you.
refreshments, so please go and imbibe yourselves. There's also a display of the wells in Mosaic, and if you want to see how you can invest in wells in Mosaic, there's an opportunity there as well. So please go and have a look at the materials and what Bruce is doing to build Mosaic, but do enjoy yourself and have a drink. But before that, no evening would be complete without some mention of Brexit. And this next song is no exception. So we think Brexit is a new thing. Well, it's not. It was being sung about in the 60s by our dear friends Flanders and Swan. I have actually taken a couple of verses out because they were just too un-PC for even me. So, anyway. Drifting up on me like that.
The English, the English are best. I wouldn't give tuppence for all of the rest. The rottenest bits of these islands of ours we've left in the hands of three unfriendly powers. Examine the Irishman, Welshman and Scot. You'll find he's a stinker as likely as not. The English, the English are best. I wouldn't give tuppence for all of the rest. And crossing the Channel, one cannot say much. For the French, the Spanish, the Danish and Dutch. The Germans are German, the Russians are red. And the Greeks and Italians eat garlic in bed. The English are moral, the English are good, and clever, and modest, and misunderstood. And all the world over, each nation's the same. There's simply no notion of playing the game. They argue with umpires, they cheer when they've won, and they practice beforehand, cheer when they've won. The English, the English are best. So up with the English and down with the rest. It's not that they're wicked or naturally bad. It's knowing they're foreign that makes them so mad. For the English are all that a nation should be. And the flower of the English are John and me. The English, the English are best. I wouldn't give tuppence for all of the best. Enjoy your drink.
education. All Brethren studies, and then he came back from the war in 1945 and started working for the family. A number of important works.
But he's best known for editing, he's best known for editing and publishing the Foray Requiem. So if you've got a copy of the Foray Requiem on the shelf, Bob's favourite is the Byron as well. It's a little throwaway piece. It's skittish, it's light, it's from a book called The Colours of the Organ, which was written sometime last century. And the intention of the book, it's got five or six different pieces in it, and each piece explores particular spots on the organ. The Caprice features the oboe, and the St. Thomas organ has a very lovely oboe. So, Mr. Ratcliffe's Caprice.
Thank you.
And this piece was written for Princess Edmonda, whose father was Isaac Singer of the Singer sewing machine.
Thank you.
right? We're experimenting on you. And so this is the inaugural performance of the intercept of the St. Thomas's Barbershop Quartet, maybe the last performance as well, we'll see. And it was Byron's idea to wear those hats, so I'm not sure they look like something off Preston Beach, rather than the barbershop, but anyway, we'll keep it.
Thank you. just the thought of you, my heart grew tipsy in me. You and you alone bring out the chips.
Thank you.
train, there was a folklore that a fellow composer was on the train and saw one of the signs above the toilet on the train and added some words to humoresque. So you're going to hear both the musical version with some of the words that were written while on the train.
Thank you. Thank you.
but for three keyboards, as you've never heard before, and probably won't ever want to hear it again. Thank you.
at the same time.
Thank you.
this bit, and then I thought, I've missed it.